This is Naoko Kanda from the Department of Dermatology, Nippon Medical School, Chiba Hokusoh Hospital in Inzai, Chiba, Japan. This video will present her clinical research, Dietary Habits in Japanese Patients with Psoriasis. Psoriasis is a chronic inflammatory skin disease showing scaly indurated erythema. It is characterized by Th17 dominant abnormal immunity and hyperproliferation, and aberrant differentiation of epidermal keratinocytes. About 20% of patients have arthritis, which is called psoriatic arthritis, abbreviated as PSA. Psoriasis patients are frequently associated with obesity, diabetes, dyslipidemia, and cardiovascular diseases. This is a diagram showing the TNF-alpha, IL-23, IL-17 axis in the pathogenesis of psoriasis. Dendritic cells secrete TNF-alpha that induces IL-23 secretion in an autocrine manner. IL-23 induces Th17 cells to produce IL-17A and IL-22, which act on keratinocytes and promote their proliferation and production of cytokines, antimicrobial peptides, or chemokines, thus inducing inflammation. In psoriasis, regulatory T cells, or Tregs, are dysfunctional and cannot sufficiently suppress the activity of Th17 cells. There are genetic and environmental factors that induce the pathogenesis of psoriasis, including dietary habits. Psoriasis patients tend to show higher BMI and higher intake of fat and lower intake of fish or vegetables compared to the reference groups. Such abnormal dietary habits and obesity in psoriasis patients may promote the development of diabetes, dyslipidemia, cardiovascular events, as well as exacerbation of the psoriasis. Saturated fatty acids, red meat, or simple sugar promote the TNF-alpha IL-23 IL-17 axis, gut dysbiosis, and suppress Tregs, leading to the development and progress of psoriasis and its comorbidities. In contrast, fish, N3 polyunsaturated fatty acids, vitamin D, vitamin B12, and soybean genistein suppress the above inflammatory signals or promote Tregs, leading to the amelioration of psoriasis or its comorbidities. To date, dietary habits in psoriasis patients have been mainly studied in Western countries, and there are few studies on dietary habits in Japanese psoriasis patients. Also, the differences in dietary habits between PSA versus non-PSA patients have not been studied. The brief type self-administered diet history questionnaire, or BDHQ, is a questionnaire regarding the diet covering the preceding 1 month based on a Japanese style of diet. The intake of energy, nutrients, and foods can be calculated from the results of BDHQ. The purpose of this research is the following 4 points. First, to study the intake of nutrients or food in adult Japanese psoriasis patients compared to age and gender match controls using the BDHQ. Next, to clarify the characteristics of dietary habits in adult Japanese psoriasis patients compared to controls. Also, to clarify the nutrients or food correlated with the disease severity. And finally, to identify the differences in dietary habits between PSA versus non-PSA patients. Subjects were 70 psoriasis patients versus normal controls matched for gender and age. Dietary assessment was done by BDHQ. Differences in the intakes of nutrients or foods between psoriasis patients versus controls were analyzed by a Wilcoxon signed rank test. The correlations between psoriasis area and severity index, PASI, and each variable was analyzed by Spearman's row correlation coefficient. The correlations between psoriasis area and severity index, which is known as PASI, and each of the variables was analyzed by Spearman's row correlation coefficient. Psoriasis patients were divided into a low PASI group with a PASI less than the median of 5.3, and a high PASI group with a PASI greater than or equal to 5.3. The differences between the groups were analyzed with a Mann-Whitney U-test. The association of each variable with psoriasis or with high PASI was analyzed with a multiple logistic regression. The differences between PSA versus non-PSA patients were analyzed with a Mann-Whitney U-test. Here are the results. First, psoriasis patients showed higher BMI and higher intakes of vitamin D and vitamin B12 compared to the control group. Second, psoriasis patients showed higher intakes of fish and shellfish and pulses, which are foods like chickpeas and lentils, sugar or sweetener, and lower intake of meat compared to the control groups. Next, we found that the BMI value was positively associated with psoriasis, and the intake of meat was negatively associated with psoriasis. On the other hand, none of the nutrients or food were significantly correlated with PASI, analyzed by Spearman's correlation coefficient. Next, high PASI patients had higher intake of confections than low PASI patients. Also, the intake of confections was associated with high PASI. The intake of vitamin A, betacarotene, and green or yellow vegetables in PSA patients were higher than in non-PSA patients. The logistic regression analysis failed to find any association of the intake of vitamin A or green or yellow vegetables with PSA. Next, let's discuss some possible explanations and related considerations of these results. First, it may be that the dietary habits of psoriasis patients in Japan are different from patients in Western countries. Japanese psoriasis patients showed higher BMI compared to the control group, like those in Western countries. This indicates that high BMI may be a risk factor for psoriasis and cardiometabolic diseases in Japan, as it is in Western countries. In contrast, in Western countries, fish, pulses, vitamin D, and vitamin B12 are recommended for psoriasis patients, but in Japanese patients, their intake was higher compared to the control group. In Western countries, psoriasis patients are recommended to avoid meat, but in Japan, psoriasis patients already had lower intake of meat than the control group. Based on these results, we hypothesized that psoriasis patients may just prefer fish and pulses to meat, simply reflecting a typical Japanese diet. Alternatively, Japanese psoriasis patients may intentionally select the dietary pattern that is recommended to improve psoriasis, that is, reducing meat intake and increasing fish and pulse intake. Next, the increased intake of sugar rather than fat may be related to the development or exacerbation of psoriasis in Japanese patients. In Japanese patients, the intake of sugar or sweetener was higher than in the control group, and the high intake of confections was associated with high PASI, indicating a relationship between high intake of sugar and psoriasis in Japan. We hypothesize that the increased intake of sugar may expose T cells to high glucose environments, leading to the increased expression of IL-17-related molecules and their adhesion to endothelial cells. The increased intake of sugar may also increase intestinal permeability and induce gut dysbiosis, leading to the suppression of Tregs and promotion of endotoxemia and Th17 activity. The increased intake of sugar may also result in obesity, which induces imbalance of adipokines in the visceral fat, decrease of adiponectin, and increase of TNF-alpha, IL-6, or leptin. These three series of signaling may promote skin inflammation and epidermal proliferation, leading to the development or worsening of psoriasis. Next, PSA patients had higher intake of vitamin A, betacarotene, that is provitamin A, and green and yellow vegetables, which are rich in betacarotene, than the non-PSA patients. We found that longer duration and higher doses of vitamin A derivatives and retinoids for psoriasis patients may induce enthesitis with ossification, mimicking diffuse idiopathic skeletal hyperostosis. Furthermore, shorter duration and lower doses of isotretinoin for acne patients may induce spondyloarthropathy, including sacroiliitis. The anthropathogenic effects of vitamin A derivatives have been reported before. Isotretinoin may cause degeneration of the lysosomal membrane in the synovium, or promote joint damage by microtrauma, including bone marrow edema or fatty degeneration. And the polymorphism of retinoic acid receptor alpha promotes these adverse effects of isotretinoin. Also, retinoic acid may enhance the expression of matrix metalloproteinase, including joint damage. Furthermore, Cutibacterium acnes may promote Th17 or Th17-Th1 responses. Based on the anthropathogenetic effects of vitamin A, we hypothesize these effects of increased intake of vitamin A and or beta-carotene. In the case of long duration and high dosage, they may promote osteoblastic differentiation of mesenchymal stem cells, leading to enthesitis. On the other hand, in the case of short duration and low dosage, they may promote synovial degeneration or matrix metalloproteinase 2 expression in joints, together with microtrauma, Cutibacterium acnes, and polymorphism of retinoic acid receptor alpha, leading to spondyloarthritis. And these two series of signaling may promote the development of PSA. In conclusion, Japanese psoriasis patients showed higher BMI, lower intake of meat and higher intake of fish, shellfish, pulses, sugar, sweeteners, vitamin D, and vitamin B12 compared to control groups. Psoriasis was associated with high BMI and low intake of meat, and the high PASI was associated with the high intake of confection. PSA patients showed higher intakes of vitamin A, beta-carotene, and green and yellow vegetables than non-PSA patients. Further research is needed to identify the significance of these results in the pathogenesis of psoriatic skin and joint lesions. We would like to thank the staff below for their cooperation, and we really appreciate those who participated in the BDHQ research. Thank you for your attention.